mill just on the other side of...
Okay, so as you can see, we're interlocked with our ropes. What we need to do is we need to detach ourselves. There are only three rules.
Hi, I'm Rob Stanley. I'm doing a PhD at UCL in systems biochemistry.
I'm Martin O'Reilly. I'm a PhD student at the Complex Centre for Biological Modelling.
Hi, I'm Linda Baylas. I'm a PhD student at Primary Care and Population Health.
So we're here at St Pancras while the Olympic crowd's around. We're milling through the station trying to find people who look bored and going up to them and asking them would they like to see some science tricks.
Have you been on the train at all today? Going on the train?
We usually make the story around the trick, try and link that into the Olympics. So there's one where we've got a copper tube and got a steel slug going through and a magnet going through. And the magnet goes slower and it's quite a cool effect. So we say that's, you know, the how you can get a fast way to the games via the javelin trains or a slow way to the games via the tube.
Brilliant. Would you like a go?
Probably the one that sort of gets them interested the most is the rope trick. So got like two loops of rope we, you know, looped onto our hands and they're tied to each other. So the trick is to untangle yourselves from each other.
There are only three rules. We're not allowed to cut the rope, we can't untie the knots, and we can't take off any of our body parts.
Right.
But apart from that, move us around and see what you think.
It's great because you can immediately hand it over to the kids to do themselves. And so they're always standing over each other and getting themselves tangled up. And they give it a good effort to try and figure it out.
And it's definitely possible.
Definitely, definitely possible.
No, that definitely didn't work.
And then in the end, it's like a little trick, you know, to pull it over, just over your hand.
Yeah, you can kind of use it as an analogy for science. You have to experiment a lot and to try and find the answer. And the trick does require a bit of out-of-the-box thinking, which lots of science does as well. So
yeah.
It's a nice way to kind of get them interested in what we're doing here.
They're taking to it more than I ever thought they would. And I mean, it helps that they're a little bit bored standing waiting in the station, but they seem to really be impressed and really enthusiastic about it.